Comes from the pollution of burning gasoline, which means when we drive cars around, we're harming the forest. When carbon monoxide contributes to 81% of acid rain.
Trees are the most harmed thing in the forest because acid rain damages the outer layer of leaves that protects it. The acid then goes into the tree and prevents the plant from absorbing carbon dioxide, which in turn prevents it from the ability to begin its natural process of photosynthesis.
The effect of the surface of leaves also makes it difficult for trees to survive in harsh weather conditions. Acid rain also creates aluminum in the soil, which takes away nutrients from it. Aluminum is not the only toxic metal deposited in the soil by acid rain. Some others that are harmful to trees and other plants are lead, zinc, and copper.
These metals are released during the fall of acid rain, and they severely restrain the growth of these plants. They also restrain the growth of mosses and fungi, which help the trees because the mosses eat the harmful bacteria that can kill them.
The main effects of acid rain are less harmful directly to trees than it is to the elements that keep them alive. High altitude forests are the most at risk because they're closest to the clouds and fog, which are even more acidic than the rain.
So basically, acid rain stops trees from growing.
The burning gas from cars can travel for many miles before it's transformed into acid rain.
Now we have two videos to show you to give you an idea of how bad acid rain really is.